This is what a perfect day is all about. Laying in the grass. Yep, it's gorgeous out here, man. It is just beautiful. Sorry about that. It is just beautiful. There's a jet in the sky way up high, flying up there, leaving a little bitty jet trail. The sky is absolutely clear, except for some seagulls flying around. It's a beautiful thing. Yeah, so it's an absolutely perfect fall day, and I have some work to do around here. I got to trim these massive bushes back away from my house, and then I gotta come down here, get in this shed down here, and clean it out. And I gotta go up back and clean some stuff out. Noah's gonna run around a little bit, and I'm gonna try to get some outdoor work done. I want to show you a huge mess that Mainly Butch created, okay? I fucking did this. You know, this is me and my fucking stupidity sometimes. I threw a bunch of junk out on the back porch, meaning to put it in storage or get rid of it. And here it sits. Covered in leaves. Look, it's the fucking Christmas tree in the box. I don't want that Christmas tree anymore. The greenhouse, it didn't quite work out because my green thumb turned fucking black. I'm going to put that up on the road and put a free sign on it. Shit that I have drug home and stored here. All this shit's got to get off this porch and into its proper places, and then I have got to go to the pool store to get a pair of bolt cutters because I memorized the password, the combination to my work lock, and in the process, I forgot the combination to my shed lock. I got to write shit down. Alright, so this is what a good butch can do in 10 minutes. Ta-da! The porch is clear and all swept up. Clothespin bag. Oh, it's beautiful out here today. Yep. Yeah, I got that done. Everything's loaded in the truck, ready to go to the dump. And I got the shed unlocked because I remembered the password. So I'm going to go work on that. Hey, getting ready to take off. Gotta take all the... I got an entire cargo bed of my Chevy S10 pickup truck full of shit for the dumpster. So, I conveniently get to use the dumpster at the pool store that I ran for years because it belongs to my family. And it's easier than sorting your trash. I know, all you recycling motherfuckers are gonna have a fit at me, but I don't recycle. I used to recycle every fucking thing, you know. I used to have bins for fucking everything. Paper, cans, plastic, fucking toothpicks, you know. But this place I'm in now is a lot smaller than the farm was. And there's no room for all those bins. So I put it all in one fucking container. And the trash man recycles it. We have trash to energy here in Maine. It goes through a conveyor belt, all the metal is sucked out of it, all the plastic is picked out of it by hand, keeps little workers up at the Merck plant happy, and then what is left is burned for energy. So, although they did just close one Merck plant down, I don't know, you know, I do know that there is a sorting procedure that happens with it. Anyway, yeah, it's a gorgeous day. There's a couple little fluffy little clouds in the sky up there, little bitty ones. Noah's with me. We're gonna do a park visit. That's right, Noah. We're gonna do a park visit, baby. Snaking her little tongue up here. And I got more work to do at the house. I did get the shed unlocked. You know, what happened is I had to memorize a time clock number for work, which is like 9 digits long. Then I had to memorize a combination for work, another 6 digits, and I forgot the combination for the house. So I miraculously remembered it in a moment of glory in my brain, and I wrote it down. So, and the one for the one at work, those other two numbers are actually written down in my wallet, although I do have it memorized. You know, and then you got your checking account number, you gotta memorize that, your ATM number, 15 different fucking pins, and yeah, it's a lot of fucking little numbers in there all jumbled up. And when I went to undo that combination lock on the shed, they got all jumbled up in my head. I couldn't figure out which lock I was doing. And it was a crisis. I actually texted to see if I could get the bolt cutters. We own bolt cutters. But then I got it open, so I don't need the bolt cutters today. More to come. hey, we got our in-town stuff done, and now we're going out to the park.
Nola saw a squirrel run up that tree, and she's now determined that she's going to climb the tree. Where'd the squirrel go? You run up the tree, come over here. Come over here. Did he run up the tree? He ran right up that tree, didn't he, Bobo? He did. You can't climb trees. You're a dog. Walking with Miss Nola. Taking her to the park for a little while. She loves this park. And she keeps, like, freaking on the trees because of the fact the squirrels run up and down them. Come on, Noli. Round the tree. Round it. Other way. There you go. There she goes. Yeah.
It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, guys. I am in Pierce Island Park, directly across from the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard, from which many people are furloughed today. I did just get a call from the guy who stays at my place during the week while he's working down here, and he said he has not been furloughed yet, so he's still working. I'm not sure that his department's really one of the ones that'll get furloughed. He's on a private contract. But he was hoping, I think. He wanted some days off. Give you a look out here at the river. Just a minute. It is one fucking beautiful day here. It's like a late August day here. This is not October 2nd for sure. Yeah, check this out. This is the river. Piscataqua River.
Ooh, and that is the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard over there. You can see the sign in the distance says Portsmouth Naval Shipyard. It's a beautiful thing. Look at all the seagulls taking a rest. Squirrels? Nola hunting for squirrels. Are they in there? Where are they, Nola? They went up that tree, didn't they? She's marching her little ass all over the place here looking for squirrels. You love them squirrels, huh? You love them squirrels, huh, Bobo?
And Noe is sitting in the grass. Who likes it? You like it? It's nice out here, huh, Bobo? Very nice out here, huh? You like your park. Very pretty park. This is what a perfect day is all about. Laying in the grass. Yep, it's gorgeous out here, man. It is just beautiful. Sorry about that. It is just beautiful. Jet in the sky way up high, flying up there, leaving a little bitty jet trail. The sky is absolutely clear except for some seagulls flying around. It's a beautiful thing.
Me mama like a wagon wheel, rock me mama in the way you feel. Hey, hey, mama rock me.
Nola and I just got a Moe's Italian sandwich. We're actually gonna go back to the park, get a picnic table and eat. They even made her a doggy pack. I can't wait to show you guys this. So we went to Moe's and got Italian sandwiches, which are just the best at Moe's in the world. And this is, they gave me a doggy pack, look. This is my Moe's Italian sandwich. This is Nola's doggy pack. They made her a doggy pack. They even gave me a cup for Nola's water. My chips and my water. Yeah, and we're about to have a picnic. We're back in the park. I'm Noli, back in the park. This is the most luscious lunch in the world, a Moe's Italian sandwich. This is Nola's doggy meat pack that they made for her. And we are gonna chow.
Nola and I just finished our picnic lunch out on Pierce Island. Yeah, it was awesome. A lot of oil in that sandwich and not too many napkins I grabbed. So, headed back to the house now, gonna tackle the shed. Get that straightened out, mow the lawn, and we might get around to starting to pressure wash the house. If I don't get it done today, I will get it done tomorrow. it's going to be another really nice day tomorrow. Not quite as warm as today, so I'm glad we took advantage of today and got out for a while. You know, just got to stretch your legs, huh, Noli? And take advantage of this beautiful weather. People are walking around town in shorts and tank tops like it's friggin' July, which is kind of funny. Oh. Yeah, the city is full of people here, this little city. Anyway, yeah, headed back home. We're gonna take a different route. Stop. Nolan's gotta bark at every little dog that goes by. Nolan and I decided to top off lunch with a Dairy Queen ice cream. Yep, a little one. So, kid size, man. The regular size ones are huge. Nolan's eyeballing it now. You want that ice cream, don't you? You want that ice cream. You gotta wait. Yep, that was about the size of our day. I came back, laid on the couch, took an hour nap, watched Ellen, and didn't get the shed done or the pressure washing done today. But I will get it done tomorrow. Hope you enjoyed seeing our day. I'll talk to you later, guys. Peace.